Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 3.2, Problem 4. This is Problem 4 from Section 3.2. It says, maximize z equals 8x plus 2y, subject to 4x plus 2y is less than or equal to 16, x plus y is less than or equal to 6, x is greater than or equal to 0, and y is greater than or equal to 0. So to solve one of these problems, it's a four-part process. Part one is graph your feasible region, part two is label the corner points, part three is fill in the chart, and part four is state your solution. So part one, graph the feasible region. So when I graph this, I only want to graph the parts of the problem that have an inequality symbol. The part with an equation does not get graphed. That gets used later on. So I'm going to start with 4x plus 2y is less than or equal to 16. And to graph that, I'm going to make a little chart next to it with an x column and a y column. I want to pretend that it's 4x plus 2y equals 16, and I want to find two points that would make that equation true. So first, I'm going to let x equal 0. And 4x becomes 4 times 0, and it winds up giving me the equation 2y equals 16. Again, I'm pretending it's equal. So to make that equation true, to get 16 equals 16, the value of y would need to be 8. And next, I get the other point by letting y equal 0. So if y equals 0, the 2y basically becomes 2 times 0 and just goes away. And I have 4x equals 16. Again, I want to pretend that it's equals. So x would have to be 4. To make 16 equal 16, x would have to be 4. So let's graph this. So one of the two points is 0, 8. So 0, 8 means go over 0, up 8. So I'll put that point on the graph. The other point is 4, 0, which means go over 4, up 0. I'll put that point there. And I'll connect them with a straight line. I'll use a ruler. Keep it neat. And I have to determine where I need to shade. Should I shade above that line or below? The way to determine that is choose a test point that's not on the line. Not on the line that we just drew. Use 0, 0 if you can. So 0, 0 is not on the line. That will be my test point. Put 0 for x, 0 for y into the linear inequality that we're trying to graph, and you'll wind up with a statement, 0 is less than 16. That's true. 0 is less than 16. So my test point was on the underneath side. The result is true, so the underneath side is the shaded side. Like that. Now, that takes care of one of the linear inequalities that I have in the problem. The next one I want to do is x plus y is less than or equal to 6. I'm going to do the same process. And I'm going to do it in a different color, just for a little more clarity of the problem. So I'm going to make a little xy chart next to it. And I'm going to pretend that the inequality is actually an equation. I'm going to pretend I have x plus y equals 6. And to find two points that make that equation true, if I let x equal 0, I have the equation y equals 6 if I'm pretending it's an equation. And then to get a different point, if I let y equal 0, I have the equation x equals 6. So now I have the point 0, 6, and 6, 0, and I'll plot that on my graph. So the first one, 0, 6, means I go over 0, up 6, and I'll put that on the graph. And the other one is 6, 0, which means I go over 0 and up 6. I put that on the graph. I'll connect those with a straight line. And hold my ruler on it. And now I have to determine whether I shade above the red line or below it. So same process. Take a test point that's not on the line that we just drew. Use 0, 0 if you can. 0, 0 is not on the line that we just drew. So I'll put in 0 for x, 0 for y, which will give the result 0 is less than 6. And that is a true statement. 0 is less than 6. So my test point was from the underneath side of the line that we drew. The result I got when I put it into the inequality was true. So the test point's in the shaded region, which means the underneath side is the shaded region. And the last two, x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0, lock you into that corner. The x greater than or equal to 0 really means that any point in your feasible region has to have a positive x-coordinate. I can't get on the side with negative x-coordinates. So it's going to keep us here. And the y greater than or equal to 0 means any point in your feasible region has to have a positive y-coordinate. You can't get below the x-axis. So now the area that satisfies everything is the heavily shaded area in my graph. Notice I didn't shade into these two outer triangles. That's a common mistake. Don't shade too much. You have to be just in the area that's shaded. You can't go out too far. You have to satisfy all the linear inequalities simultaneously. So step one, graph your feasible region, is now complete. Step two is label your corner points. So one of the corner points is 0, 6. And again, be careful, not 6, 0. 0, 6. 6, 0 is not a corner point. 0, 6 is a corner point. 0, 0 is a corner point. 4, 0 is a corner point. And the intersection of the red line and the blue line also makes a corner point. Now, because it's a pretty accurate graph, you can probably try and read it right off the graph. But most people draw these graphs freehand, and it's not accurate enough to try and read it off the graph. So the way you're supposed to do it is take the two inequalities that are intersecting and solve them simultaneously. So take the inequality 4x plus 2y equals 16. Let me write it over here. 4x plus 2y equals 16. Don't continue to use it as an inequality. Make it an equation. And the other one that's intersecting is x plus y equals 6. So there is a process from chapter 2.1 that shows how to solve simultaneous equations. What we want to do is choose one of the variables and make the number in front the same number but with opposite signs. So I could go with 4x and negative 4x, or I could choose to go with 2y and negative 2y. You'll get the same answer either way. The y's are probably easier to deal with. So I'll take the top equation and leave it the same. 4x plus 2y equals 16. Nothing will change. The bottom equation, though, everything's going to get multiplied times negative 2, not just 2, negative 2. Negative 2 times x is negative 2x. Negative 2 times y is negative 2y. And then negative 2 times 6 is negative 12. So now one of my variables has the same number in front but with opposite signs. So now I can add my equations together. 4x plus a negative 2x is positive 2x. Positive 2y and negative 2y cancel. Positive 16 and negative 12 will be 4. And now I can solve for my 2x equals 4. Divide out the 2, I'll have x equals 2. So now, this point of intersection, the x value is 2. To find the y value, you can take the x as 2, plug it back into either of the original equations to find the other variable, and you should get the same answer either way. The bottom equation of x plus y equals 6 is the easier equation. So if x is 2, y must be 4. 2 plus 4 would make the equation come out to 6. So now I have my corner points. And again, because I drew this with a ruler, over 2 up 4 does look very accurate. So step two of my four-step process is, step two is label the corner points. We've done it. Step three is fill in the chart. So I should be able to fit my chart right about here. So the first column of the chart lists the corner points. The middle column, which I make a little bit wider than the other columns, lists the object function, which for this particular problem is z equals 8x plus 2y. And the last column is output. Make a few rows to keep it neat. List all the corner points. One corner point is 0, 6. Another corner point is 2, 4. Another one is 4, 0. And the last one is 0, 0. I know that can't be the maximum, but I'll include it. So put the x and y values of each corner point into the object function. So in the top row, my corner point is 0, 6, meaning x is 0, y is 6. So when I put 0, 6 in the object function, I get z equals 8 times x becomes 8 times 0, and 2 times y becomes 2 times 6. So now 8 times 0 is 0, 2 times 6 is 12, 0 plus 12 is 12. The next corner point is 2, 4. So z equals 8 times x is 8 times 2, plus 2 times y is 2 times 4. So 8 times 2 is 16. 2 times 4 is 8. 16 plus 8 is 24. And the next corner point is 4, 0. So z equals 8 times x now becomes 8 times 4 at this corner point, and 2 times y is 2 times 0. So 8 times 4 is 32. 2 times 0 is 0. And when you add 32 plus 0, you get 32. And finally, the bottom corner point of 0, 0 is going to give me an output of 0. You're going to have z equals 8 times x is 8 times 0. 2 times y is 2 times 0, and when you do the math, you get 0 plus 0. So the output there is 0. So step 3 of my 3-part process was to fill out the chart that we just filled out. And now the fourth step is state your solution. So we want to maximize this. Our possible outputs are 12, 24, 32, or 0. Well, the biggest output is the 32. So when you state your solution, I will say maximum of 32, and I have to say where the 32 came from, so I'll put at the point. So that output of 32 came from the point 40, and the 32 came from the point 40. And that's the answer for this one.